Welcome to the EA Sports Tournament of Legends. And fans, the ever so popular tournament bracket. Tonight we've got two skilled big men that'll be going toe-to-toe with one another. Number 30 might be one of the best floor leaders in the country right now.
The player we'll be matching up with tonight is also a great leader. It'll be interesting to see which one can compel his team to victory.
Well, Dick, let's get down to the court and let's get the action underway. We're ready for the tip. And with a tip of the ball, the game begins. They work it around the perimeter. Number 32 is called for the foul. First team foul. That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. They work it around the perimeter. Unloads. Can't put it down. The small forward with the ball. On the dribble, gives it up. He puts up the J and come up short. Number 24 handles the pass.
Day he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
10 seconds to put it up. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebound in the building.
And a momentary look from three-point land. On the inside.
Did a great job protecting the basketball, seals the defense off, and explodes to the basket.
Here comes a pick.
Hey, ball screens are such an important part of the game these days. Guys are so creative when it comes to using that ball screen.
Goes up for two. Perfectly executed.
Frustration right there.
Now in transition.
A good fast break always results in a bucket, Brad.
Kicks it out. Seconds to put it up. He shoots from outside. He nails the bucket. Defense is the focus for them now with a coach shouting out orders.
Great anticipation defensively.
Number 21 receives the pass.
Nice stepping it, man. Take a look right here. Little Barishnikov in shorts, little ballerina hanging in the air.
He's a jack of all trades. Gave it up. Tries for two. Can't get the shot to drop.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. What's even more important?
There's the rejection.
They just keep shutting the door.
They've got him trapped here, Dick.
Look at that trap, Brad.
Hey, dodge one there, Brad. Escape the trap.
Man might be in a little bit of trouble here, Dick.
Great pass out of the trap, Brad.
The power forward handles the feed. Now they work it around the perimeter. 10 on the shot clock. For two. And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline. And with Dick Vitale, I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. In terms of balanced teams, what might we expect from them game to game, Dick?
Brad, they like to balance the attack. They don't feel like they can always play up-tempo or always play in the half court. Therefore, they mix it up and do a little bit of both. I think this style works for them.
Wide open. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
I'm sorry, Brad, but this young fella seems to be their only hope at the moment.
On the dribble, gives it up. Jumper. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Both teams looking to get things going here. A little two-man action.
Up and inside!
There's a bad pass right to the defender. The Spartans looking to attack in transition.
Great basket off the two-on-one.
Pushes it up. For the bucket. Perfectly executed. Check it out here. A nominee for our Pontiac game-changing performance. Charles receives the ball. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open. He blocks the shot. Pushes it up. Puts it up. He gets that one to fall. Now let's take a look here at the tempos for both these teams tonight.
Well, it looks like both of them are going to be battling to see who can control the tempo and put pressure on the opponent.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
This team right now just lighting it up from everywhere.
Hey, they're finding each other in rhythm with their passing, Brad. That makes a huge difference in how shooters shoot.
Great composure to pass.
There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
Moving it around the perimeter. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
But he missed the shot. Number 31 gets the pass. Tries for two. Up and in. Number 52 receives the pass. He intercepts it. Gave it up. For two. The land. For the bucket. Perfectly executed.
He almost found himself in some trouble there, Brad.
That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post-play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Kicks it out. Ten seconds. He makes the block. Perfectly executed. Well, whose team tempo went out? That's a question right here, Dick.
You know, Brad, tempo is always important. Every team has their philosophy, and it's up to the players to follow the game plan.
And back they come the other way. Number 52 with the ball. There's a high percentage shot.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
Vincent handles the pass.
Dump it inside.
Puts up the tray. Shots off the mark. And there's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
Well, Brad, as the meter indicates, the game has been pretty balanced in terms of tempo. Some short possessions and a few longer ones.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Tries for two. Up and in. Number 32 gets the pass. Both teams are looking to get something going here. Ten seconds on the shot clock. Turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability.
Had him in the paint, but went elsewhere. For two. The layup. Working it around the perimeter. They've got a three-point shooter spotting up. For the bucket. Up and in. They're far from settled on defense.
Hey, the rotation needs to tune up, Brad. And they'd better do it quickly.
Well, it's still early, but Dick, let's take a look at our player matchup.
I tell you one thing, they're not disappointing at all. They are really responding in a positive way under pressure.
Looking for a good shot. Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. Donnelly receives the ball. Tries for two. Dickey simply on fire.
Hey, call the fire department, baby. This one's burning up.
They work the perimeter. Goes up with a shot. He misses the J. On the outside. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Kicks it out. Looks at the three. The Wolverines have got to continue to get him the ball.
Brad, he's on fire.
Donnelly handles the pass. On the outside. Blocks it.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops?
Seems as though fatigue is set in for some of these guys. For the bucket. The layup.
Spacing.
Goes up for two. Up and in. Fires away. That was nice. There's the tempo for the game thus far.
Hey, currently the tempo is definitely on the high side, Brad.
They'll work it around the arc. Blocks the shot. The ball goes out of play. Number 55 gets in on the action for the first time tonight.
He has a great presence when he steps on the floor, Brad.
Now the high screen. Ten seconds showing on the shot clock. Lloyd handles the pass. For two, the layup. Who'll be able to use their tempo and come out with a win here, Dick?
Well, it all comes down to execution. If you can put points on the board playing your style, your opponent will have to make adjustments that may affect their tempo and what they will do well. Trapped really well there, Brad.
Fed the low block. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. He gets the rebound. The shooting guard with the ball. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
For the bucket. Up and in. We take a look here at each team's tempo, Dick.
Hey, the key to this game is not just who will set the tempo, but who can control it throughout the game.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Did a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Goes up for two. Dick, you think they're going to stay this hot?
Hey, it doesn't look like they're slowing down, my friend.
Looking for a good shot. On the shot clock. They look to get it to the inside. Fake and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
They work it around the perimeter. That's
spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
On the dribble, gives it up. Tries for two.
The lay-in.
Two. Perfectly executed.
Check it out here. A nominee for our Pontiac game-changing performance.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
These fans seem to be thrilled with what's going on right now in front of them.
What a reaction, Brad. The fans are loving it. Hey, dodge one there, Brad.
The power forward takes the pass. Off the mark. And there's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
Two teams are picking and choosing where they want to push the ball, Brad.
Gave it up. For the bucket. Perfectly executed. Shot clock is dead. And a momentary look from three-point land. Goes up for two. Up and in. At the half, the Spartans are down by four. If you missed the play of the half, here's another look. Well, with one half in the books, why don't we revisit those points of emphasis, Dick?
These players know their strengths and weaknesses, and up until this point, they haven't played to their strengths. Very poor job thus far delivering on the points I brought up earlier.
It's all about doing what you do well, isn't it, Dick? It's such a simple concept. Let's see how these guys do in the second half. Michigan is showing some deadly accuracy from the field in the first half.
Hey, for sure, Brad. This kind of accuracy can easily be carried over to the second half if they continue to be patient with the luck. Patience and poise usually equals points.
Dick, two great players now heading into the second half. We watched them through the first half, and they played it pretty dead even. We'll see what happens here in the second half.
I tell you, there's no doubt their PTP is their primetime performers. They like the big moment, and they make big plays.
Gets it to go.
That shot will end up getting you on a poster.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Perfectly executed. Tries for two.
The lane.
For two. Up and in. Charles receives the pass. It sticks. power forward gets the ball. Ten on the shot clock. Number 35 takes the feed. Down inside for the bucket. Perfectly executed. On the dribble, gives it up. Up for two. The lay-in. He's in the clear. He drains the trifecta. Good job defensively. Here they come now on a turnover.
I tell you what, pressure. Look at him take the ball to the left of the court. No one stopped the basketball.
Picks off the lazy pass. The center takes the pass. Did he get there?
With anticipation by the young guy.
That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
Passes it out of the trap.
Escape the trap.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important they'll have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He can't get any more open than that. He sinks another basket. What are they going to do with this guy, Dick?
I don't know, Brad, but they better do it quickly.
Tries for two. Up and in.
Their defense is absolutely horrible.
They are not putting up much of a fight. Donnelly receives the pass. Cross court. He shoots from the low post. The Spartans have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
They need to keep feeding them the ball. It's simple.
He better get rid of it. Now they work it around the perimeter. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that block shot.
Number 31 gets the pass.
Up it inside.
Two. Doesn't go. Who'll be able to use their tempo and come out with a win here, Dick?
Well, it all comes down to execution. If you can put points on the board playing your style, your opponent will have to make adjustments that may affect their tempo and what they will do well.
Forward handles the pass. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block.
Great shot block right there. And some good movement on the offensive side.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. And his shot rejected. Blocked! Nice job defensively. There's the block.
Transition opportunity coming up.
Moving it around the perimeter. For two.
The lane.
Number 52 receives the ball.
Dump it inside.
The open jumper. The Spartans have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
Daddy's on fire.
The small forward handles the feed. They get an open three. He doesn't get the hoop. Donnelly receives the pass. Looking to move it around the perimeter.
I love that block shot, Brad. Really gives you a lot of momentum.
Pushes it up. For the bucket. Off the rim and no good. Gave it up. Seconds left on the shot clock. Goes up for two.
Up and in.
Looking for the pick now.
Hey, the two-man game is great to watch when you have an intelligent dribbler and a skilled big man.
The center handles the feed.
Wow, look at him rotate over.
And a slam.
Two. The Spartans have got to continue to get him the ball.
They need to keep feeding him the ball. It's simple.
He gets the rejection. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
10 on the shot clock.
The lane.
Goes up for two.
Up and in.
Number 24 takes the pass. Working it around the perimeter. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. Vincent handles the feed. Looking for a good shot. Dribbles around the trap.
Right around the trap.
Cross court.
They get an open look for three.
Gets it to fall.
There's a look at the current tempo for the game.
It's definitely been a slower paced game, Brad. Very few opportunities to push the ball.
Now trying to feed the low block
for two. Perfectly executed. On the dribble, gives it up.
Great defensive play. Anticipated well. When you're an anticipator, you got a chance to do well. A lot of guys, they're reactors. If you're a reactor, you're one step behind the action.
Nice rebound.
Better get out and fill the lanes, Brad.
As we continue to track the game's tempo,
these teams are selectively pushing the ball and looking for transition opportunities.
For the bucket, the land.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad, in regards to our player matchup, the coaching staff has expected it to be evenly matched up across the board all night long. But you wonder, who's going to be the first one to throw the punch?
All right, thanks, Erin. Erin Andrews, our sideline correspondent. All of you know that with an additional insight there. Goes up for two. Number 35 picks up the defensive foul. First personal foul. He goes to the line for the first time. He makes the first shot. Second one is good. They've got him right where they want him, Dick.
Great pass out of the trap, Ryan.
Pushes it up. Now looking to attack. Gave it up.
Great composure to pass it despite the trap, Ryan.
They work the perimeter. Tries for two. And he missed. On the outside. Vincent picks up the foul. First team foul. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
He almost found himself in some trouble there, Brad.
College basketball is special to me for that reason right there, Dick.
Listen to that roar. It's unbelievable.
Everybody into the act right now, and you can tell by the cheerleaders on the sideline how things are going.
Isn't that what makes college so special? The enthusiasm of the cheerleaders, the mascot, everybody involved.
The shooting guard handles the feed. Well, Mr. Vitale, it looks like we're in for a great finish here.
Hey, down the stretch, there are so many factors that could become the difference maker. Turnovers, missed free throws, rebounded. I wonder what it'll come down to in this game.
On the outside. He takes the three. He gets the bucket to fall.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Steals the pass.
Look at that spacing.
Puts it up. Not a great decision there to shoot the ball.
That I can guarantee you, that he's not the guy they want shooting the ball.
They'll work it around the arc. Jump hook from the low block.
I'd say great job protecting the basketball, getting deep post position, and the jump hook is so effective.
Number five receives the ball. A lot of people can't hit that shot anymore, Dick, that 10-12-foot shot.
Yeah, the medium-range shot is an extension.
Dumps it in. He takes the wide-open shot. He is just lighting it up, Dick.
He's beating his man to the spot and hit the shots, Brad.
The power forward gets the pass. He takes the open jumper. Questionable shot selection there.
That shot was definitely ill-advised.
Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Goes up for two. Knocks it down. On the dribble, gives it up. Tries for two. Up and in. There's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
Quick shots, Brad. That's why the tempo gauge is where it's at.
Gave it up. Here comes the ball screen. He shoots the jumper. He misses the J. Number one gets the ball. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
He hits a bullseye again.
Hey, he's feeling it from everywhere, baby.
Looking for a good shot. Rejected out of there.
Nice block shot.
The ball goes out of bounds. Well, Dick, it's obvious to me that they are starting to heat things up right now.
I'll tell you one thing. They're getting good shots, and they're making them count. They're in a groove, baby. And when they're in a groove, that court looks like an unbelievable Atlantic Ocean instead of a teapot.
The shooting guard with the ball. For the deuce. Off the rim and no good. On the dribble, gives it up. Seconds to shoot. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. He pulls down the rebound. Long pass down court. For two.
It's a two possession game if they can score here.
We got a timeout on the floor, and with that, let's go courtside to Aaron Andrews.
Brad and Dick, with limited time remaining, the coaches will have to figure out their offensive and defensive strategies for the next few possessions. What they will discuss or fail to discuss during this timeout could be the difference, guys.
Talk about a roller coaster ride. You've been on it before. It takes a kind of a special person to be able to call the shots from that sideline.
There are so many highs and lows, Brad. You just hope that you are preaching the right stuff to the kids. You just hope that when you're stressing and asking them to do, they understand and can pull it off.
Dumps it in. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. He grabs the rebound. That's a matter of clock management, isn't it, Dick?
I'll tell you, it's time to start fouling in order to stop the clock.
And the clock stopped with a foul. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Picked off. Timeout. The second slowly ticking away here, Dick.
Hey, they got to trim this lead if they want to have a chance to win this thing. Sometimes timeouts can take teams right out of their rhythm, Brad. Let's see what happens here.
They work it around the perimeter. He looks for three.
The more possessions you create, the better your chances. I knew this was going to be a dandy, baby.
The lead is down to three. He goes to the line for the first time. He makes the front end of the one and one. Gets his second.
They need points on this possession, baby.
We've got a timeout on the floor. Do you think they switch things around here for the moment, Dick?
I don't think so, but we'll wait and see, Brad. A 5-point lead could go either way with this much time, Brad.
Oh, it certainly can, Dick. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
Opportunity now for an easy one. Makes the shot. They have found their stroke at the stripe tonight, Dick.
This has always been an excellent free throw shooting bunch.
Makes his second shot. They're seeing them all fall from the line tonight.
That's a crucial plus down the stretch, Brad.
Thank you. It's always interesting to see who's still hot and who's not after a timeout, Dick.
Well, you gotta think, the shooters might be the most effective, Brad.
Final thoughts, Dick. What are they?
I love these points of emphasis because they are a great guide for teams. Accomplishing most of them will likely result in a win. Staying away from your style will result in a poor performance. To me, Brad, it's an easy decision to make.
Well, Dick, it's all about playing your style and doing the things that your team does well. If you can manage to play your style on a regular basis, you're going to be successful. Sometimes it's just that simple. This play was unbelievable. Without a doubt, today's Pontiac game-changing performance. Dick, we're taking a look back now. We've watched this marquee matchup throughout the ballgame. How do you think it played out?
Well, I think it played out fairly well, but it's all within the realm of the team. The one thing I like about the Stars, they're playing as a unit with their teammates.
Michigan State saw their lives flash before them as they finally pull this one out.
But two teams like this, you knew the game was going to be close.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler. Good night, everybody.